Nice to meet you. We last met was during Choked. It's been exactly a year.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Thank you. Nice meeting you too.
Yeah, nice meeting you again. So now I saw the trailer of your film. I mean, I was just reading about it and you said you were a little wary and you wanted some time before you committed to this project because you didn't know whether you would fit in with this character of Ibrahim, who is one of the central protagonists, as well as the people you were working with. So I personally was very surprised, you know, because usually you have young actors who say, yes, I just jumped onto it. But hearing that from you, I was like, not bad.
Yeah, because Ibrahim's character is very distant from who I am, what sort of an upbringing I've had, my past, my context, everything was different. And the project was, when I first heard the story, it was almost like it was going to start rolling immediately, almost immediately. So I just wanted to make sure that while I love a challenge, and the most satisfying experiences mostly come out of when you're going in scared about something, and I like that. I just wanted to make sure that it wasn't, that I wasn't stretching too much. And it's such a purely out of the amount of respect I had for every actor in the cast. I didn't want to be the weak link.
So Prithviraj is producing the film. He is also Ibrahim, and his character are the ones who, you know, the duel is between the two of them. So what was that experience like?
It was lovely. See, it's always great working with Prithvi. I first got a brief taste of it when we did this movie called Coup Day, directed by Anjali. And I had very few scenes with him then. But I love the energy that he carried. And I came out of that film wanting to do more with him. So Kurdi sort of came in as a blessing that way. And here I get to work with him. I got to work with him extensively. So almost all the scenes that we have in the film are with each other. So that way it's brilliant. And it's also just like so refreshing and inspiring to see someone who is, who's done over 100 films, who's been around for so long, has worked with every, you know, possible exciting creator in the industry, and still gives so much weightage to the basics, like showing up on time and, you know, being available for your co-actor, the sort of like open to a complete give and take during a scene. Just still seems as excited about the process of filmmaking as I was when I started, you know, doing films, when I did like my first two or three films. So it's, and like day in and day out, I see him coming in with this and, you know, staying, keeping that energy going till the end of shoot that day. So yeah, Prithvi's very inspiring to work with that way. There's a lot to watch and take note of.
And now this is a crime drama. So also I noticed was, you know, the scenes are dark because, I mean, that's what the director said, that they had shot during the night, you know, extensively been shot during the night. So what was this experience like coming on board for this project, the shooting, and also getting under the skin of your character? Was there any prep you did? Sometimes actors tend to zone out, tend to, you know, keep themselves away just to get in that zone, because Ibrahim is pretty complicated.
Yeah, he is. And there's always a lot of prep to be done for every character, all the more so for Ibrahim, because like I said, he's like, I didn't have anything in common with him pretty much. So there was a lot of work to be done, all very abstract work mostly, because it's got to do with trying to understand or trying to reach as close as you can to the frame of mind that Ibrahim has been in for a while. And, you know, you catch him at a very vulnerable position in life when the movie starts off, and that sort of helplessness, or that sort of lack of the very will to continue living, if you don't understand that well enough, I guess everything from then on becomes almost impossible to play, because how that changes is Ibrahim's arc through the film. So yeah, the prep was mostly directed towards that, just about trying to understand this person and what his everyday is like.
You know, Roshan, I must tell you, I was reading comments, viewer comments about you. So one thing that stood out was Roshan Mathew, the game changer. Malayalam cinema. So when you get those kind of accolades, because you proved your filmography in the last year and a half, I think you've seen what, at least three films starring you, or a little more than that. So, and those accolades coming your way, what do you make of it?
It doesn't make any sense really, because the game has been pretty good in Malayalam forever. So you don't really need a game changer. It's just about trying to do the best that you can with the opportunity that comes your way. Because I find myself very fortunate right now to be able to work with the kind of people that I am collaborating with. And I did not see that happening maybe like 2 or 3 years ago. So for me, it's like when I get called by Prithvi or by Mahesh Narayanan or Keetu or Fahad, it all feels like a dream come true, because I've watched their work and I've loved it so much. And that's what these people are, the ones who keep inspiring me to try and be better. Because eventually, obviously a certain part of you just wants to be better for yourself, but the idea behind trying to do better work is also so that you get noticed by and get called for projects involving these people who are doing far superior work. So that is the aim always, and they keep upping their game with every project that they do. You know, I don't think any of the people that I'm following in Malayalam excitedly are plateauing in terms of their work. You know, they're always like doing one better than the last. I think trying to make myself worthy of their projects more than anything.
You're being very, I would say, gracious also, and how do I put it? You're also like, I mean, it's nice, you know, usually, I mean, yes, I mean, it also does get overwhelming, the kind of pressure that comes in your kind of profession. But
yeah, and I'm very scared about letting all of that in also. So I try to keep myself at a distance and try to stay objective about the work as much as I can. And I know when I've done good, satisfying work and when I've done bad work. And it's not like my days of doing bad work is behind me. So that is the reality. So there's really nothing else to be than humble.
Totally, you're totally modest about this. But tell me, you worked with Fahad also, you've worked with Prithvi also. I mean, both very different kind of, their approaches to what the craft is very, very different. So what has been your one observation of the two? Because, you know, in Fahad Fazil also is called the game changer and breaking the type. So what has been your observation?
It's lovely watching both of them. And like you say, you very rightly pointed out, extremely different in, you know, how they, or at least how the work seems from the outside. So Fahad works again like completely dependent on the team around him who are making the film, and he works very inside out from the character, and his excitement comes out of trying to explore that character in that particular situation. And, you know, trying to see what all is possible. So everything is a possibility for him. Every tiny line or moment in a scene, everything that his co-actor is throwing at him, all of those are the possibilities that he goes after. With Prithvi's, apart from, you know, everything that he already is and what I've already mentioned, he also has an immense amount of understanding of the medium itself. And because he's also a filmmaker, I think, and he's always been one, even before he directed his first film. You could just tell from the way he approaches work. So I think he has a very clear idea of how it's all going to come out. And he knows how to change things, you know, align things a certain way or plan a certain moment so that it comes out the way he wants it to, or the way it's intended to. So that sort of perspective, I don't think many actors have. It takes an actor filmmaker, I guess, to have that kind of perspective. So yeah, two entirely different ways of working. But one thing that I found in common in these two and a lot of other senior actors that I've worked with in Malayalam is that it doesn't matter how big a star they are. There is no hierarchy that spills over past the word action, and there is no distance that you feel like you have to maintain they purely just feel like your collaborator, your co-actor, and that I really enjoy.
And it's awesome, you know. Malayalam films has always been giving us great content, but the last 1 year, 1.5 years, people have woken up to, I say, two kinds of cinema. One is everybody wants to watch Korean cinema, which always was there, and the other is Malayalam cinema. What do you think has done it? Why have people suddenly realized the treasure trove of stories that have come from Malayalam cinema? Now it's just like a league apart.
I think Malayalam cinema has suddenly become a little more accessible than it was before. And yeah, huge thanks to the OTT platforms there, because it's not like it was impossible, but it would take some amount of, you know, work and to get your hands on a Malayalam film, I guess, earlier than this. So now with it being available at a single click's distance with subtitles, which are good. So that I think makes a huge difference. That breaks through a lot of the barriers which should have been broken a long time ago. But yeah, like late as it may be, I'm very glad that it's happening now. And just the fact that I can go to Bombay. And, I mean, I lived in Bombay in 2014, was there till about 2017. I've had friends from there who've stayed in touch through all these years. But suddenly in the last 2 years, these people know the films that are coming out here. Almost every film poster that I put out or share, whether it's mine or not, if the title is in Malayalam, I get so many texts asking for the title to be written in English so they can search for it. That itself means a lot. Now, people in Bombay or people around the country know names of not just actors over here, but the filmmakers here as well. So, yeah, those things are very exciting.
That's really heartening to see also, because having grown up in the South was earlier, you know, this is a North Indian thing, where they would just brand everything from the South as one.
Yeah.
Not realizing that there are four film industries there, you know, but now I'm happy they are making that demarcation and watching that content.
Exactly. I personally have friends who used to use the term South Indian film industry who have now started talking about Malayalam films and Tamil films and Telugu films in Canada. Yeah.
And you know what, I must tell you something. Having grown up, my initial years were in Kochi. The only thing in Malayalam I know is Pala Madhuram. That's it. But thanks to the subtitles, I manage now.
Yeah. No, it's good enough. I mean, you don't have to learn the language. Long as subtitles work, I feel like movie communicates. It's just that it's not like everything that you're feeling comes from the line itself, right?
I know from Malabar, Pananta, Avial, Appam, and all I knew, but not another language. But yes, food and cinema helps us, you know, break barriers. And,
lovely.
You know, and talking about you being in Bombay, just wrapped up, Darlings. What was that like? If you could just give us a little sneak peek your experience with Ali and Shefali.
It was lovely. It was entirely different to everything I've done before, which is what I was looking for. I wanted a completely fresh experience. Ali Shefali and Vijay are incredible. They are so talented. They're so good. I haven't seen one weak moment played out by either any of the three of them, and I wasn't even surprised, because that's what I went in expecting from them. I'm really glad that I got to work with them, play with them a little bit, and more than anything, it's been so, I didn't expect it to be so fulfilling to just watch them work. That's been a big takeaway.
Fabulous. And before we wrap, this is one question I've ended up asking everyone. All the talented actors I've been speaking to come with an engineering degree. And now I'm convinced engineers are not taught engineering, they're taught filmmaking and engineering.
Or maybe everyone just ends up in an engineering college before they figure out what they want to do in life.
Could be that, because everyone I meet is, what have you done before? Engineering. And I'm like,
Because see, most of the people who end up in industries like acting and theater and, you know, be films or theater, I think we're all a little clueless about all things by the time we wrap up school, because there is only so much that I come from a small town in Kerala called Changanashiri, and when I was in school, and not even exaggerating, when I was graduating from school, I couldn't name more than maybe like, 5 or 10 professions. I didn't know there was, I quit engineering college, I went to Madras Christian College. I didn't know there was a stream called political science that you could pick up and learn. you know, so we only have that much exposure. So anyone who doesn't precisely know what they want to do sort of ends up in engineering, because within that there seems to be a host of options, and you know, but like somewhere along the line, thankfully, a lot of us figure out that that's not what we want to be.
That's why I just want to tell everyone, I want to become a good actor, join engineering.
Yeah.
Is not doing that way, you. But anyway, lovely chatting with you. And since it's an Onam release, your favorite binge food, like Onam Day, and which is that one?
Oh, with Onam, I really enjoy it. So the avial is a pretty like standard dish, okay, in Malayalam. Anywhere you go and have a lunch, you will have it. But there is something special about the avial on Onam Day when it goes with everything else, and how well it goes with like a paripuri and nehi and avial. So like I really enjoy it. Like that's what I think I most look forward to, like a nicely made perfect Onam avial.
Onam food and Kuruthi. So I think our Onam is done. Happy Onam. Thank you so much for speaking to me.
Thank you so much. It's lovely talking to you.
Same here. Likewise. Thank you, Persian. Take
Bye.
care. Bye.